Two steps pretty easy. It's just walking and turning. And in this video, we're gonna give you three keys to improve your turns for country two step.
What's up, gang? It's Brian B.
And Miss Megan.
And we find that people struggle in two main areas in turns. Number one, balance. Number two, multiple turns. We're gonna address those both in this video. Now, we have a full course on spins and turns. We're gonna link that up in the corner, but let's cover these two key areas.
So we talk about balance. We have to establish a point of balance. We call this a post. So regardless of what type of turn we're doing, whether we're rotating around this in chenille turns for country two-step, or whether we're doing a pirouette in a solo dance form, we have to establish a balance point. So the very first drill we're gonna do is we're gonna leave our left side forward. This would work with the right side as well. But the left side forward, we're gonna step forward. We can take a heel lead or a toe lead, doesn't matter. But we're gonna line up our hip, our rib cage, and our head over the ball of that left foot. We're gonna take the right foot off the floor and we're gonna find that balance point. That's number one, finding a balance point. Number two, we're gonna jump right to the meat and potatoes. We're gonna rotate a half turn to make sure that you found that balance point. So we're gonna get to this position, we're gonna push off this toe, rotate a half turn over the ball of the left foot. We're gonna rock back and we're gonna do it again. Now this drill would work in half turns or quarter turns or full turns, but half turns seem to be a good medium. Now, when I get to this position, I want to be able to stay balanced and not have to put this foot down.
So to improve your balance, I have a drill from skating. What we used to do is we would balance on one foot. For right now, I would make sure you're doing it on a flat foot because trying to do it up on your toe is way harder. So I'm just gonna use my left leg right now. We're going to lift our other one, put our arms out, okay? That is going to make your ankle stabilization muscles work as well as your feet. So you're gonna try to do this with your eyes open, arms out, and try and balance. Once that's not so hard, you're gonna try and close your eyes and take your spatial awareness away. So you're gonna do the same thing and close your eyes, and your ankle has to play around and find your balance point.
All right, now that we've got our balance taken care of, let's talk about multiple turns.
All right, so for multiple turns, there's two things we need to know. We know the first part. We know that we need to have a post that we're balanced over. The second is a rotation step where the actual turn occurs. So a good example, if we think about an outside turn, something just as simple as this, a quick, quick, slow, slow, right? If we use just that basic, we need to establish a post. So in establishing a post, we establish Megan down line. That looks a lot like our balance drill that we did before, right? That's the first step. We have to establish a post down line. Then Megan's gonna have a closing step. We call the combination of these a chenille turn. So she has a closing step. Then we have to create another post and a closing step and a post and a closing step. So regardless of whether we're spinning quick, quick, slow, slow, or quick, 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 or even to a small degree, quick and quick and quick and quick and like our opening sequence, we have to establish the post. That's the first part. And then we have to establish a closing step. So Megan's gonna talk you through this a little bit about what she thinks about in her own body.
Talking about closing for our turn, I talk about this with a line through the middle of your body. You're gonna close one side to the other. So for me, my whole right side is forward. I'm gonna close my left side to my right side. So we're gonna close, and then we're going to post again and be all the way over our foot. So again, we're gonna close one half to the other, close and open.
So if you're struggling with multiple turns, what we really need to understand is that there's no such thing as three turns. It's one turn completed three times. Megan already broke down the footwork for that. So let's talk about what we can do as leaders to make sure that we maintain that for the followers within a pattern. If I'm leading a double outside turn, a quick, quick, slow, slow, I have to understand that Megan has two parts of that turn, a step and a turn and a step and a turn, or in some cases, a turn and a step and a turn and a step. We'll cover that in our course. We'll link that up in the corner. But I have to understand that I have to put her on that foot first, then she fires the turn. So it's as minimal effort for me. I put her on the foot and she fires the turn. And as many times as I do that, I can lead multiple turns. Now, if you're still struggling with that, what's gonna happen is, and I'm gonna do this going this way, is if I step forward and I leave this side back like Megan did in her demonstration, I close. The biggest key at this point is to reestablish that post. Notice this side's back. If I make a small mistake in that and I fire this through and I don't leave this back, I'm probably still gonna have enough energy for the next turn, but at this point you can see what's happening and then the third turn falls apart. All right, so to recap, you need to establish a post, be balanced over it. If that's troublesome, use Megan's balance drill. Second, you need to be able to differentiate between the post and the closing step. We call those a Shanae turns. They're typically done on quick quicks. Slows are gonna be pivots. We cover all that mumbo jumbo in our course, linked up in there or the description below. And then third, leaders, you have to understand that there's a posting step and a closing step on all of your turns, and that will let you spin almost as well as Miss Megan. I hope you found that video helpful. If you want to check out more of our videos, you can do that right here. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel. And if you're a country dance fan, head on over to Country Dance Online. It's like Netflix for country dance. What are you waiting for? Go on over there. We'll see you on the other side.